Well, did you know your employer is required by law to give you some time off to vote? In tonight's Decision 2020 coverage, Katie Crowther breaks down what you need to know ahead of the election.
Laws around giving workers time off to vote vary by state, but companies, both local and national, are starting to take a stand, trying to reduce any barriers to the ballot box. The busy kitchen at Small Pie in Bayview will be dark on election day.
We have the day off.
Small Pie and its sister restaurant, Honey Pie, will be closed on November 3rd to ensure all employees have the opportunity to vote. Owners say it's the right thing to do.
It kind of falls on employers to allow our employees to have the day off. We definitely are trying to encourage them by giving them a paid day off as well. A lot of our employees are actually working the voting polls this year.
Walmart, Target, Old Navy, and Warby Parker among the national retailers giving workers paid time off to vote or serve as election workers. And hundreds of other companies across the country have adjusted their policies to make voting more accessible to employees.
We see so many people not being able to vote for so many different reasons. So the more people that can band together and help people get out to the polls or vote absentee or whatever people's preferences would be amazing.
By law, workers in Wisconsin get 3 hours unpaid to vote on election day, regardless if it appears they'd have time before or after their shift to vote. But you have to notify your employer before election day that you'll be taking that time.
Voting is important across the board, I think. I've always been an avid voter, but this year feels really poignant for voting.
It's important to note the Wisconsin law does not extend to in-person absentee voting. You're only allowed that 3 hours unpaid time when the polls are open, and the polls are only open on election day. In Milwaukee, Katie Crowther, TMJ4 News.